Turn the mic on, shall we?
Ha ha ha! There we go. I pulled a Kakarist. I muted myself here. Maybe I should keep myself muted today. Anyway, so I was saying, BJ Waller here for another episode of Extra Live Stream Team, Monday afternoons, 1 to 3 p.m. Yes, here we are, back again, our second Monday. It's awesome sauce. No, I need this. Here. You want that out of the way? There you go, thank you. I Daddy needs his papers, so he knows what he's going to talk about today. Yes, it's quite the menagerie here again, folks. Quite the menagerie again. And we have our guest stars all over the place. What? What's the matter?
It's right there in my hand.
It's right there in your hand. Yes, that's where it went. Right there in your hand. Don't get like your father now. Come on. Nope. Stop. Okay. Don't start acting up again already. I got 2 hours to go here, kiddo. Anyway, yes. Extra Life for Kids. What is Extra Life? Well, Extra Life is a way for us as gamers to give back to our local communities by playing games and raising money for kids. It's that simple. We are part of the Children's Miracle Network of hospitals. And you might be familiar with Children's Miracle Network because of the stylized balloon up there. Most of your, or a lot of your local businesses at one point or another probably had some sort of fundraising event for the Children's Miracle Network. And it's either through those balloons where you just donate a dollar, you write a message on the balloon, they stick the balloon up there on the wall. Or like my local Sam's Club, they have like a little candy sale. You buy a candy bar for a buck and then you get your name on the balloon, they stick it to the wall and that kind of stuff. So all sorts of different stuff. Well, that's what Extra Life is, only in spades. It's for us, it's for the gaming community to come together to do something positive. That's soup. You already had your soup. Don't make a mess of the soup. You got soup in your hair. Oh my God, you got rice in your hair. No, don't. Daddy needs his soup. He's not feeling too well today. Yes, a bit under the weather. No, stop. You want to sit in your high chair?
Yeah.
You just wanted to get down. Yes, as we can see, yes, the child, she was so well behaved until, of course, I hit the start button. There we go. Okay, you gonna sit down? At least I'll keep her out of trouble. I'll hop you in because I've got to get going here. Here we go. The people are waiting for Wand Wars. Okay. We'll move this stuff over here out of harm's way. There you go. All right. There we go. Are we good? Yes. There we go. Okay. There we go. Let's confirm this too, by the way. So you can see Wand Wars. There we go. It's even better. What? No, you're not going to eat daddy soup. You said you were done eating soup. You can sit there. You sit there and listen to daddy now. As boring as that may be. Ha ha ha. There we go. Let's get all set up here. Now, as I was saying, yes, Extra Life is a way for us as gamers to come together and be real life heroes for kids, more or less. And it's really, you can do it in three simple steps, really quick, really easy, and it's free at the base level of it there. But step one, you just go to www.extra-life.org. You sign up. Like I said, it takes just a couple of minutes to put in the information you need to put in. Pick your hospital. If you're going to play on the team, find your team and join the team. If you're going to create a team, have people play with you, you create your team right then and there, or you just keep on going and you play solo, which is no problem whatsoever. And then you get your customized page. You get a template, so you're really good to go right out of the gate after you're done signing up, because the page does have a default template and stuff. And as soon as you're signed up and your sign up is complete, you're good to go. You can start your fundraising, and that's step two. You go out there. You go tell your friends and family what you're doing. You tell your coworkers, hey, I'm involved with Extra Life, and you explain to them what Extra Life is, where you're going to go play games and you're hoping to raise money for your Children's Miracle Network Hospital. 100% of which, here's the important thing, 100% of everything that is donated goes directly to your hospital. So there's no skimming off the top, there's no administrative costs, no fees or what have you taken from these donations. 100% of those donations goes directly to help the kids in the hospital that you have chosen to represent. So that's step two. Step three? Well, step three, we're going to kind of showcase what step three is here, and that's playing games and hoping to raise money. But instead of hoping to raise money, which, hey, I always hope to raise money whenever we stream anyway, we're going to be talking about Extra Life. So we're going to be playing games, talking about Extra Life for the next couple of hours. And hoping, encouraging everybody to sign up and make donations. And yeah, and have fun. At the end of the day, that's all it's about. It's really about having fun. Injured finger here. You have to make it. Oh, here comes the garbage truck. Like I said, a virtual menagerie here. Yeah, but hey, that's all part of the fun and ambience, isn't it? Okay, Wand Wars. What is Wand Wars? It's a little indie game here. As I should mention too, we get rewarded as participants. Besides the good feels for helping kids, there are a few little kickbacks here. For meeting certain low-level fundraising goals, we do get rewarded. You know, we get game keys, game discount keys. We get a discount code for a nice wooden smartphone case. All sorts of good stuff. And again, it's free to sign up. It's free to participate at the classic level. But if you do want to upgrade yourself to the platinum level, you can do that while you're signing up, or you can do that anytime after your initial sign-up procedures. Just a $15 registration fee, and bang, you're already a platinum participant by paying that $15 fee. And that ups the rewards. You get an Extra Life t-shirt if you meet $200. $500, you get a nice Olympic-style silver Extra Life medallion. $1,000, you get a gold medallion, so very, very nice. All this stuff. But again, you know, those are the kickbacks we get for being participants and meeting certain fundraising goals. So we get a little kickback here as part of the Extra Life stream team. Aside the fact from being able to stream, put ourselves out there and talk about Extra Life and just having fun with all our viewing audience out there, we get a little bit of perks and stuff there too. Obviously, of course, I've played Train Valley in the past as a little perk that was provided by our stream team leader, Hero by Clicking. So again, thank you, Hero, for that. Real cool game. I'm glad I picked that game. A lot of game codes he gave out to the stream team for us just to have fun with. And definitely having fun with Train Valley. We'll be playing more of that in the future. But Wand Wars here too. A little kickback to the Extra Life stream team. We got game codes for this little indie game called Wand Wars. And Wand Wars is, let me look here, it's a Steam game. It's described as an action indie sports game, so that's interesting. The developer and publisher, small, obviously indie, is Moon Radish Incorporated. So I've not yet played this. Of course, I did want to highlight, you know, this at some point because it was, you know, part of my participation here in the Extra Life stream team. So, hey, I want to give a shout out to the Extra Life team for being able to, give us a little bit of kickback on the stream team as well. So very, very nice. Here, keep that over there, will you? So we're going to see what this Wand Wars is all about, why don't we? Enough talking. Let's get on with the playing, shall we? So let's take a look here. I think I might want to knock this music down a little bit, although I might drown out the child. Yeah. You're too noisy right now. You gotta be quiet. I need to be quiet. Are you gonna be quiet?
Yeah.
Okay. See how long this lasts. Oh, children are such a blessing, aren't they? Maybe I should highlight my game window. Now this looks like this is obviously a gamepad control, but I can play this on mouse keyboard, which I am doing. Escape start. So you got your gamepad controls here, and then the corresponding keys here. So catch, C, use item X, chicken hex, V. Interesting. I'm not going to remember that, but I assume that's what the tutorial is going to be all about. Find out in a minute. Let me grab some of my tea, my throat. Excuse me, I am under the weather a bit here. I got a nasty chest cold. I'm trying to fight here, so I got my tea here. Got my tea here to try to break stuff up there. Got my chicken noodle soup right here. My little lunch here, chicken noodle soup. Then you need to be quiet. Well, I can't get it now. You're out of luck. But okay, so we got that. Escape controls, settings, game volume, music volume. Okay, looks like we're good. Full screen off, obviously. Make my aspect stretch, screen shake. That's interesting. Play vibration, content mode. There we go. We good? We're back? There we go. Oh, my microphone cord now. Okay, there we go. All right, let's get on with playing it. Let's quit. No, we don't want to quit. We want to play the tutorial. Let's see what this is all about. Let's play some Wand Wars. P1. You're late, apprentice. Space bar. Are you ready to learn the basics of Wand Wars? Space bar. As you might know already, this is a Merlin sphere. No, I did not know that already, but thank you for telling me what it is. And I assume now you are Merlin because you look kind of Merlin-esque. Spacebar! The sphere's magic is powerful. Spacebar. Nobody really knows how it works. Except me, of course. Anyway. Cast your catch spell to deflect the sphere and make it yours. Aha! Evis, hey, Devil Melody, hey, how old is my co-host? She's 2.5. No, you don't need that right now. Never heard of Wand Wars. Yes, neither did I until we were able to, I need the excellent, now cast again, hold the sphere to charge it, okay. So we as the stream team members got the movement here. Okay, let's move. There we go. Okay. All right. I gotta hold it. When holding, you can also aim the sphere. Okay. All right. But yes, my co-host here is 2.5, if you cannot tell already. Then you need to keep it down. But yeah, Wand Wars, as I was saying, is we got a key for the game for being members of the stream team here. So I figured finally came up in the schedule where I got all my RPG games out of the way that I wanted to play on the streams. Whoa, that's getting bigger. And, I'm getting very distracted here by this game. And all my city building games and all that stuff out of the way. So I figured, hey, let's throw some Wand Wars in here and finally see what this is all about. That's a good indie spotlight. I do indie spotlights on my own channel once a week. So I figured, hey, good, indie game. I can do an extended indie spotlight here today. This is pretty cool. I could just do this the whole 2 hours. But anyway, there we go. Holding until fully charged will increase the sphere's energy, as I can see that. Hitting an opponent with your sphere will eliminate them from the arena. Oh, so this is sort of like dodgeball, it sounds like. I will summon some practice pumpkins. Defeat them all. Pumpkins, oh. Oh, hey, whoa. Oh, I got somebody. I assume I'm not supposed to get hit with this thing, so. Oh, got you. Oh, two of yous. All right. Wow, this is Now this is multiplayer. This is a multiplayer. I did see an option to play multiplayer in here in one of the menus when I was prepping here earlier. Oh, just missed him. Yeah, so this is a digital version of dodgeball here. Oh, it would have hit him too. Come on. You serious? It missed him. Oh, there we go. Good aim. Really? Thanks. Try charging your magic arrow and aim it at V to charge magic arrow. And aim it at the ball. Okay. V. Ooh. Interesting trajectory. You put the ball into a floating state. Okay. It's slow and completely harmless when it contains the dark magic of an arrow. Let's proceed to the next challenge. Time to form more tricks, is it? Okay, tricks. Now we see where I'm sure I'm going to start struggling a bit here. Charge a magic arrow and aim at the training dummy. Okay, V. Ah, how amusing. That's how you turn your enemies into defenseless chickens. Okay. Something more to remember here. The longer you charge, the longer they stay. So I have unlimited charge here because when I caught it to charge it, it was very quick amount of time here. So let's see here. Okay, so there is a limited time. Okay. Charging also makes the arrow faster, as we saw. On to the final lesson. Oh, excellent. I guess you assume I'm going to actually be ready to play this. Wand Wars arenas are filled with mysterious spells. Ultimate power-up magic will help you obliterate and outwit your opponents. Here's another training dummy. Collect a power-up gem, face the target you want to aim at, and use the magical item. Okay. Bomb took my gem. Okay. Use the magical item. Okay, I gotta press X to use a power up. Oh! Alrighty then. Alright, I just have terrible aim here. Wanna get down? Okay, give me a minute here. Let me, So I basically anticipate where this guy's gonna go. Missed him again. Come here, wanna get down? Alright. Hold on, here. Boop, there you go. Yeah, you're fine, you can play right there. Oh, you're gonna sit next to me now, so I've got to move everything again, is what you're telling me here. Okay. Try not to make a mess here. Okay, stop. No, don't touch the keyboard. We know what happened last week when you tried to do that to me. Alright, let's see. X. Use my power up. Let's see if I can actually hit this guy here. Oh, got him. There we go. Got him. Exception. Okay, thank you.
Can you catch your face? Oh, it's a lot.
What? Oh, I missed what he said. He calls that a lesson? Yeah, exactly. Call that a lesson? Are you crazy? Okay, tutorial. So let's see. Versus up to 4 players, okay. The trials, 1 or 2 players. And we can play story. I guess we can do story here. I got it, yes. I guess we'll do story. Why not? Let's figure out what this story is here. No, you can't eat my soup. If you want soup, you're going to have to sit down in your chair. I'll give you soup. Come here, sit down. Is that what you want? You want soup?
Yeah, I can eat daddy
soup. Yes, okay, fine. You can eat daddy soup. My God, you need a nap. She usually gets like this when she needs a nap, and she needs a nap. There you go.
No, I need my baby.
You need your what? Oh, your bibby? No, your bibby's over there. Hold on.
There you go. Eat your soup.
Perhaps we might get some peace and quiet now, eh? All right, here we go. Oh, my God. Maybe I should rethink this idea of having co-hosts, hmm? Oh, okay, there we go. All right, here we go. Let's play the story. The Apprentice. Born to a life of video games and hockey, well, not so much, Gregory was unexpectedly scouted by a prominent sorcerer. Growing tired of the endless trolls and chicken coop cleaning, he decided to ditch his mentor and took off with the sorcerer's wand. Born to a life of video... Oh, we just read that, didn't we? Okay. Normal. Legendary. Yeah, okay. So there's no easy mode. It's not going to be pretty, I think. Okay, normal. Stop new. Let's go. Let's see what we can do here. You summoned me, Gregory? See. I was just... Wait a minute. Is that my wand? You little thief. Return it immediately. Oh, great. I play a thief. Okay. Oh, I play a thief with an attitude here. Merlin's court. Oh, okay. I play Merlin. I have to fight Merlin. Maybe like being a chicken, Gregory. Great. Try me. Okay. Alright, let's move here. Ooh. What was arrow? Arrow was V, wasn't it? Ooh. Uh-oh. Got him. Now I got a catch here.
No.
Ooh.
No.
I just lost. Alright, got him. That was just rather luck there, I think. Alright, here. Round three. Alright, here we go. Oh, man. How long have I been with Extra Life? This will be my fifth year of doing Extra Life. I started back in... I guess we'd be 2013 now, right? 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. Yes, 2013. Alright, so where are we? Oh, you need your drink now. Oh, it's about... Here we go again. Here you go. Back in 2013 when I initially found out about Extra Life through playing Defiance, which was the Try On Worlds meet cross-media experiment. Try On Worlds has a team every year, so they around October really, they started talking about Extra Life and the team. I'm like, well, what's going on here? And then they said, oh, we get all sorts of digital goodies for being on the team and stuff like that. I'm like, oh, digital goodies, hey, let me find out what Extra Life is. That's basically how I found out about Extra Life, and I realized, hey, this is something I really want to be able to do for my hospital. And first, second, three outs, one hit. And so that's basically how I got started, and then it just snowballed from there, essentially. So, you know, year after year, I've looked more into it and tried to raise more money. And then, you know, this past year, this past summer, I found out about the Extra Life stream team, what we're doing. So I figured, hey, it's something quick, something easy that I can do to help promote Extra Life even more as being a member of the stream team. So I joined the stream team over the summer. And here we are, year five, and going into my second year very shortly of the stream team. All right, let's retry this. Okay, here we go. All right, let's not get fancy here. Let's just try to catch this ball. Oh man, I tried catching it.
Oh, man.
Wow, how'd he dodge that? Oh, you bum. Oh, got him. That was just lucky. Yeah, I can see how this game would probably be a whole heck of a lot easier with a controller. Oh, I got him anyway. Alright, there we go. Not that I'm any good at these type of games anyway, but still. Oh, I almost had him. Almost had myself there. Okay, it changes color based on who threw the ball, so it's a danger to me now. I gotta catch this ball here. Oh! Oh, that was...
Help me!
Oh, he caught it. Ah, yeah, he had me there. There's no way I was getting him there. Okay. Wow. Ooh. Oh, jeez. I didn't hear much about until another by the name Orcris mentioned what he'd done. Yes, Orcris. Yes, another fellow member. What? Another fellow member of the stream team. And he does a lot of neat stuff. I've actually watched him stream his creative stuff, and it's amazing what Orcris does, so. Yes, and that's essentially why we're here, as part of the stream team, is just to let everybody know what Extra Life is all about, and encourage people to sign up right there at www.extra-life.org. Because at the end of the day, it's quick and easy to do. And now I figure I play games anyway as often and as much as I can. So why not do it for a good cause here? Gotcha. Oh, wow, that was a lucky shot. Dang it. I was not ready for that. I was not ready for that. Oh, I can't believe I missed him. Yeah, he let me win that one. There we go. 45, 55, alright, we're okay here. We're okay. Oh, versus the kitten, eh? Okay, here. Meow? Meow. Using a stolen wand, I see. Yes, unfortunately. As are you. Oh, kitty cat stole the wand too. Ready to play? Here we go. Yeah, so I'm not exactly sure how this advances a story here. Oh, take that, kitten. Wow. That was pure luck, by the way. Okay. X. And again. Oh, and that did not work out too well now, did it? Wow, thanks for that. This cat's gonna get me here. Oh, take that. Oh, God. Oh, you're all done now? Okay, good. We'll put that right there. Okay, here we go. Oh, God. All right, there we go. Hey! I don't know how I came away with winning that one. I do not know how I did that. Hey, June. Okay, that's June. Prepare to be amazed by my new powers. Yeah, not so much. Ha, I know a few tricks, too. Wonderful. Tricks? Okay. Oh, you'll see. I'm sure. Oh boy. This is a pumpkin patch. 4 points. Okay, so we gotta get 4 points here. Round one. Fight! Oh! Your baby? Okay. Oh, I gotcha. My God. You made a mess of that soup, child. You're done your drink too? Okay, thank you. Okay, well, you're gonna have to stay there because now you made a mess and I don't have time to clean you. Okay, yes, I'm in trouble here. Wow, he obliterated me there. Lovely. Yeah, you made a mess here. You made an absolute mess. There we go. Clean yourself up. All right, we're gonna have to retry this because that was absolutely ridiculous there. Already? You gotta be kidding me. I run right into it. That was terrible. Okay, here we go. Here we go. Okay, there we go. You're gonna have to wait. No idea what that was. It doesn't matter because it got me. You're gonna have to wait now. You're gonna have to sit down and calm down. That's all there is to it. Hey, look, I got a point. See, it's no fair. She starts out with a power up. My catch ability doesn't pop up in time to stop it. Unlike theirs. Beautiful. Oh, gotcha. Gotcha there, though. Okay. Yep. I ran right into that. That's beautiful. Beautiful. Gotta be kidding me. Do 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 do. Of course. That was inevitable. Lovely. Oh, of course. Yeah, of course. I can't even catch a power here. Hey, at least I got something. Oh, look, I got power too. Amazing. Fat lot of good that does me. Shield, shield, shield! Yeah, it's inevitable there. Yeah, I don't like story mode. Oh my god. I don't know how I did that. And I come back right with that, don't I? Well, that shield didn't last long. Yeah. Of course. That was beautiful. Beautiful. Getting tired now, aren't you? All right, well, enough of the story. See if we can't do see what the trials are about here. The apprentice leaderboard. So what's the leaderboards? Global. Hey, nobody. Okay, get back. Excellent. The machine. Machine versus the witch. The witch, the beast. The beast, the demon. Demon, the challenger. Vampire, wizard, sorcerer, pumpkin. And back to the apprentice versus the machine. Okay. Ready. What this is all about here. Welcome to the Endless Trials, okay. If you're familiar with the basics, go ahead and enter the portal. No, not yet. You're still here? You must be curious about the trials. Yes, yes, I am. That's understandable. Okay. The portal will transport you from challenge to challenge. Each trial will be more difficult than the last, of course. Even so, you must grow stronger as you collect magical cards. You pick a new perk every card. Excuse me. Pick a new perk card after every trial you complete. Oh, okay, here we go. Most cards stay in your deck, but some are single use. You also find spell cards, which will greatly aid you in the challenges. But you can only hold one such spell card at a time. What else? I think that's enough, because I'm already confused. Oh, beware the Mad Knight. Oh, lovely. Their magic is quite unpredictable. Freeing them will occasionally reward you with strange and unique perk cards. Go on there, the portal, see how far you can get. I'm going to wager it's not going to be very far. Oh, we don't have a second player. Okay, so that's not going to help me at all. It's supposed to be one or two players. There we go. Okay, that's better. All right. I can see you're fading now, aren't you? Okay. Yep, let's go ahead and enter the portal, because you gave me the basics. Here we go. Let's see what we can do here. Trial number one. C. Oh, that's just beautiful, that. Wow, 10 whole points. Oh boy. Oh, well, there we go. 2 for 1. Hey! Become the ultimate bro by summoning bumping fists. You should take it. Yeah, sure, we'll take it. Gain 2 respawn gems. Excellent health. Enemy stay hexed, 20% get a shield on every respawn, last two trials. Hey, I kind of like that. We'll go with that. Trial number two. There we go. Stay hexed for half as long, gain one respawn gem, accelerate the sphere 15% faster. Yep, Co-Star is out now. Hey, Sunset Straw, hey, how's it going? AKA Steph, what's up? How you doing today? It's time to test your skills. Wonder Harry the Cold. Okay. Oh, come on, really? That's just lovely, this guy is. Who got ya? Got ya. Got ya. Oh, I think I got him. I don't know how, but I got him. Of course, I'm frozen now, so that doesn't help. Oh, good. Oh, I get some more respawns here. Let's see what my card... 20% chance to freeze your enemies on Hex. Take it? Sure, why not? Okay. See, I'm doing a little bit better here on the trials than I was the story, for crying out loud. Gain one respawn gem, make your room 50% faster, reduce spell card... let's go haste here. Trial number four. Okay. Yeah. Are you kidding me? Oh, I ran into that watching the ball. This is nuts. This game looks adorable. It's it's adorable. Yeah, it's adorable, all right. Yeah. Oh, we're back to trial one? Okay, yeah. That was just lovely there. Oh my god! Go. Woohoo! Oh, I buy so many bumping fist cards. I guess I should try to use some cards here, but I'm not exactly sure how to do it. Bubble up. That's one trial, that doesn't help. And so every time, respawn gems. Let's work on the respawn gems here. pardon me. Yikes! Well, I got you anyway, once. I gotta catch this thing so I can charge it up more. Try not to get hit here. Yep. Oh, man. Mage Beam. Casting Mighty Beam. Space to use spell card. Okay, I take it. I think we'll use this one for this trial here. One trial. Oh, that might come in handy. I'll do this one though. Mormigan the Ninja. Okay. Oh my god, he has this too? Oh my god. Yeah, there's no way I was getting away from that. Catch the ball! How'd he catch the ball? Seriously? Nope, there goes my shield. Oh, I got him. I don't know how I got him, but allies friendly on hex. What's this one here? Transform into a sentinel cloud. Ooh, I like that one. I only got 3 power-ups for this next trial here, and I had 7, and I got nowhere near it. Oh my god. Just watching you own at this game. No. No. Yeah. Everything you see that happens in my favor is by pure dumb luck here right now. I can't even use my hex arrows here now. Alright, so space to use the card. So this is the one I want to try to use this card here and see what happens here. Space. C, 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 C. Oh, I caught it! He caught it. Oh, he caught it. Oh my god! Oh, of course I respawn right up there, naturally. My god! I cannot physically catch the thing that fast. Oh my god. Now let's go back to the main menu here. Okay, I got the trial 4 anyway. Holy moly. Alright, the young one's falling asleep, so let me, you know what, let's run a little commercial here, because Extra Life United is coming up, and we'll talk more about that while I clean up the little child here. So, yeah, so we'll head back to story mode after our little break here. I'll be right back. Yes, okay, make sure I click the right scene here. Yes, Extra Life United. Probably the second most anticipated event all year for Extra Life. Extra Life United. This year it is the weekend of March 23rd through the 25th. So the 23rd, 24th, and 25th. It's usually 3-day weekends. It's going to be held down in Disney World in Orlando, Florida. So if you go to the Extra Life site right here, where you can, of course, sign up to become a participant. You have to be a participant in order to attend Extra Life United and get all the information, the costs, reservations, all that stuff. Make your reservations early, of course, if you do plan on going down. I have not yet been able to attend an ELU event. But I heard it's a lot of fun. We actually have quite a few people right here on the stream team who have attended past events, and they say it's a real blast. It's real fun. I mean, how could it not be? It's essentially a gaming convention, more or less a 3-day gaming convention. There's gaming tournaments, all sorts of fun, different activities each day. And you get to be able to meet some of the kids that we're helping that we're helping to heal. Essentially, at this point, there's champions. I think each hospital selects a champion to represent them at Extra Life United. So it's all great fun. Meet great people. Play with the kids, have fun. Like I said, great tournament, and you can win money for your hospital as well. If I understood some of the information I was reading correctly, so that's even better. But yes, Extra Life. Going into our second hour here of our 2-hour block. Once again, I am BJ Wilder, aka Real Millennium Group. Like I said, I do play for the Children's Hospital of Philadelphia out here on the easterly coast of the United States. The CMN hospitals. Oh, that's not that. That's my own command on my own channel here. If I do it this way. Yes, if my broken tablet wants to type correctly, here we go. Boom. Can also catch me over at BJ Wilder. That's where I do all my variety gaming, in addition to my Extra Life fundraising. Like I said, you know, 3 easy steps to sign up. It's quick, easy. It's free if you participate at the classic level. Again, if you you can sign up to become a platinum level participant at any time, either while you're signing up for the first time each year, or anytime after you sign up in that year. The calendar year, the fundraising year for Extra Life is January 1st through December 31st, and you can fundraise all year long, like many of us do. I haven't really gotten too heavy or hard into my fundraising yet, but this coming March, in fact, it's going to be March in what? 2 days. Wow. March is almost here. I'm going to start doing more and more Extra Life streams on my channel, so be sure to catch me there. I actually have a schedule I'm going to try to stick to as well, so that'll be fun. You'll actually know when you could most likely catch me streaming. Again, I play for the Children's Hospital of Philadelphia. I am a member of Judgment Gaming. Like I said earlier, talking with Evis341, I initially learned about Extra Life through Tryon Worlds when I was playing a couple of Tryon games, particularly Defiance at the time, is when I started hearing about Extra Life. And I was actually a member of Tryon Worlds team the first couple of years, and that's really great stuff. Like I said, now we get rewarded. There's benefits for being a participant that everybody talks about and mentions. But one of the things that usually doesn't get mentioned too much is the fact that there's a lot of corporate sponsors that help Extra Life do what Extra Life does. So 100% of the donated money gets to go to the hospitals instead of, you know, having administrative fees and all that nonsense. So some of, you know, like I said, Trial Worlds is a member, XSplit, Rooster Teeth, Wizards of the Coast, who does the Dungeons & Dragons games, Twitch here, of course, which we are streaming on, Humble Bundle, which we've talked about in the last couple of episodes. There was a bundle that was specifically created for a week or two, I think, that the proceeds helped or went to Extra Life as well. So good stuff there. In fact, I've picked up a couple of Humble bundles the last month or so. They've got some really great deals there. But so I was saying, Trial Worlds, I was a member of Trial Worlds team the first 2 years I did it. And you get to play with the devs. That, you know, long story long. You join the team, you go in game, they play all their games, you know, for the games that do have guilds like Rift, you know, you can actually join that year's team guild in Rift, and you get all sorts of bonus stuff, and like I said, you get to play with the devs and the community folks in each of the games, so that's really cool. As a gamer, hey, there's nothing better than being able to play a dev's game with the devs themselves, and you know, get a little few perks there as well. And of course, during the gaming weekend, the main event, National Game Day, as we call it, Tryon it runs special events in game as well. I know in Defiance there was an Extra Life vendor where you can get specifically Extra Life branded equipment and guns and stuff like that. In Tryon there were special Extra Life rifts. Or again, in Rift, there are special Extra Life rifts. I wasn't able to do Archeage or Trove last year, so I don't know exactly what they had in those games. But yeah, it's great stuff. It's great fun to be a participant, and at the end of the day, it's great fun for a great, great cause. Again, you know, that's how I learned about Extra Life. This is my fifth year doing Extra Life. I am currently a member of Judgment Gaming now. And Judgment Gaming is just a group of five of us, I believe, we had for this past year, 2016, who met through Star Wars The Old Republic, a guild in Star Wars The Old Republic. And so, as we were talking, as we were playing Star Wars, we got to talking, and Extra Life comes up, of course, say, hey, I do Extra Life. Oh, I do too. Hey, we should create a team and put on a team. So that's what I've been doing the last couple of years there as well. So great fun hanging out with my mates. Occasionally you'll see Battery H pop in here and watch one of our streams as well, in addition to, of course, all our cool mods and other stream team members. So yeah, it's great fun. And you know that I should talk about why I do this. You know, obviously it's great fun for a great cause. We get the great rewards and all that stuff. So yeah, it's all additional perks for doing it. But really why I've done it for the last 5 years, I mean, it's sort of a little bit mercenary as well. I mean, it's not just to help the kids in my hospital. I am a father, of course. We had the young one doing her thing the first 45 minutes or so here, making it quite interesting. But, you know, I've got two children, and fortunately they've been in relatively good health, you know, just the usual childhood ailments here and there. Nothing really dramatic or traumatic. Certainly nothing like what a lot of these kids go through in their hospital, or the, you know, my hospital, the Children's Hospital of Philadelphia. You know, they treat kids with cancer, they treat kids with birth defects, serious injuries, serious illness, all sorts of stuff. These hospitals are really specialized, and really they need this might operate at top efficiency in order to be able to afford things like research and medical equipment and all sorts of that kind of stuff, so they can really be essentially on top of their game to be able to treat these kids with all sorts of stuff, really, and do their best to keep these kids alive and have a great quality of life. And the money doesn't go just to the treatments and that kind of stuff. It also helps fund things like art classes, music therapy sessions, all court stuff that helps kids be kids and helps take them out of what they're going through, even for a little while. That's an important thing to note. So that's why it's really important to me, because right now, you know, my kids are healthy, but you never know what the future can bring. You certainly never know, with the way the world is and just, you know, how fate, I guess you could call it, deals its cards to you. You never know. So I want to make sure that, you know, even though my kids haven't had to use the services of the Children's Hospital of Philadelphia, that I am doing what I can to make sure CHOP is operating at the best ability it can operate, and that, God forbid, that if I ever should, if we ever should have to take one of my kids to the Children's Hospital of Philadelphia, that, you know, I know that they're going to get the best possible treatment there, for whatever, you know, we may have to end up taking them there for. So that's what I do. You know, it's close to home. It hits right here in the fields, I guess you could say. You know, we have a lot of stories, video stories that you'll see a lot of us Extra Lifers play during our streams. And it's basically a story about a child who needed the services of their local hospital. And, you know, we've got a few stories with, you know, happy endings, or as a happy an ending as you can have in some circumstances. But then we do have some stories that are, you know, not so happy endings. And, you know, despite the best efforts of the hospital and stuff like that, you know, the child who is the focus of the story did not survive. And so that, you know, that's one of the goals, you know, ultimately deep down for me is, you know, to get as many people participating in Extra Life as possible, because at the end of the day, we want to have more, far more happy ending stories than we do these sad ending stories. And that's only possible if we have people sign up to participate, and it's even more important to have people donate, of course. I mean, everything we do here is for naught if we can't, you know, get the word out there and get people to be very generous and donate their money through the gamers to these hospitals. And these hospitals are all across North America, Canada, the United States, and Puerto Rico. But don't let that stop you either from participating or donating. Obviously, you can donate from wherever you are in the world to help a sick child get better. But you can participate too, no matter where you are in the world. You can be an Extra Life participant. And like I said, you know, we've got you know, a couple of guys on the stream team who play for a Puerto Rican hospital. But I also understand we have somebody from Germany who is an Extra Life participant. When he signs up, he just picks a hospital to support, because at the end of the day, the money that we raise here is going to help a sick child get better. And it doesn't matter where in the world these children are. You know, if we can help a child out there get better, that's the best possible thing. So at the end of the day, you know, anybody can be a participant. Like I said, it's free at the basic level. It's quick and easy to do. All you have to do is have some fun, play some games. You don't have to do a 24-hour marathon. You can break that up however you want throughout the entire year. You don't have to raise thousands upon thousands of dollars. You know, even a couple of bucks really can make a difference in kids' lives. I mean, that was one of my campaigns this past year. It was $1 at a time. That's what the Children's Miracle Network is known about. Like I said at the top of the show, you know, the Children's Miracle Network, their fundraising is known for those little balloons that you find your local business that you give a dollar for to write your name on. I mean, that's just $1. That $1 can go a long way. I know somebody had mentioned about specialized infant bottles that are specially made to assist children who are born with cleft lips or mouth deformities be able to feed off of a bottle. Now, these bottles cost only a couple of bucks. So even if you can only donate or only raise $1 or $2, that makes a big difference. That buys a bottle for one of these children, and that can make all the difference in the world to that child and to survive. So $1, $2, yeah, that can go a long way to make a difference in a child's life. And like I said last week, one of my things I'm going to keep bringing up this year is that, you know, it's great that we encourage everybody to come and sign up and participate, but it's more than that. You know, one of the things that we've mentioned here among ourselves on the stream team is that, you know, the average gamer, I think, average participant raises $100. Now, of course, we have many participants who raise thousands upon thousands of dollars. Again, you don't have to worry about that. You just do the best you can. But then the unfortunate part is that we have many, many participants who don't raise anything at all. And that should never happen. I mean, at the end of the day, you know, what I guess maybe some people just don't realize is that you can donate to yourself, and that's very important. You know, if you're a new, even whether you're brand new to this fundraising idea, or you've been doing it for all 8 years, all 9 years that Extra Life has been around, one of the most important things, I think, if you're doing any sort of fundraising venture, is to show that you have taken the initiative yourself. Donate to your own cause. If people see you donating to your own hospital, donating to your own cause, that will make them more inclined to support you and donate to you, to your hospital. So nobody who's a participant should ever finish the fundraising year with zero amount raised. $1, just donate $1, $5 to yourself is all it takes. I mean, sure, yeah, we know money can be tight, stuff like that, but again, $1 can really make a difference. $5 can make an even bigger difference. You know, if you donate $5 to yourself, that can get the ball rolling for more people to support you and support your hospital. So always remember, you can always donate to yourself. I do it every year. I've donated, you know, $10, $20, sometimes over $50 to myself, depending, you know, on what sort of fundraising gimmicks, I guess you could say, I've done here and there. You know, I have a Lego store, so I run a special all month in that Lego store that every sale, 10% of everything I sell, I will donate to myself, to my cause. So I raised a couple of bucks like that last year. So that's all it takes. All it takes is a couple of bucks to make a difference in the child's life. So be sure to sign up. Be sure to donate, support yourself. That's the most important thing you can do. And then come up with fun, fantastic ideas to fundraise. You know, like I said last year, I did my $1 at a time. I did my Lego store fundraiser. So just think out of the box. Think crazy ideas. This year, my crazy out of the box idea is to take this wisp here, all these little graying hairs here, and I will color them purple. Yes, the color purple I've decided, because it's my favorite color. This year, if I can raise $1,000 for my hospital this year, I will dye my hair purple for my marathon. And that's the one thing that's great about Extra Life. You know, you can play PC games, you can play, you know, board games, tabletop games like Dungeons and Dragons, you can play mobile games, you can play Facebook games, you can go outside, play tag, play baseball, go to your bowling center, bowl a bit, go to your mini golf center, play mini golf, go to your regular golf course, play a couple rounds of golf. If it's a game, it counts. But again, you don't have to do 24 straight hours. If you want to do 24 straight hours, that's great. Just be safe, which I'll be talking about in a minute here. But yeah, you can break it up if you want to break it up. You don't have to do it on National Game Day, which is November 4th and 5th, I think, this year. If you have another weekend that works better for you, that's great. Do that weekend. If you have several weekends in the year, that you can do, you know, mini marathons or major marathons, stuff like that, you can do that too to fundraise. Like I said, you can fundraise however you want all year long. The only commitments we ask is that, you know, you do your best to try to raise what you can, and you do put in 24 hours of gameplay for the year, which is, you know, pretty easy to do, really. But yes, I start my marathon Friday evenings, and I go all the way into Saturday evenings. Again, it's going to be a 25-hour marathon because of daylight savings time. Or saving time. There is no S at the end. Oh, itchy nose now. But, yeah, so if I can raise $1,000 before November 3rd, because, I need time to dye my hair, I will most certainly dye my hair, and I will absolutely record it and put it up on my YouTube channel as well, the process of dyeing my hair purple. So that's one of my crazy fundraising ideas. I mean, you can come up with something for yourself. I know Sean Rooney, who is one of our stream team members, and, you know, his family is actually a focus of one of our stories here for Extra Life. You know, he did the thing of, you know, shaving his head, shaving his kids' heads, you know, and waxing his back, stuff like that. Just crazy stuff. So, I mean, you could even do, say, you know, during your marathon, you can say, hey, this hour, if anybody donates to me this hour, I will match that donation dollar for dollar, or, you know, 50 cents for each dollar donated, stuff like that. So stuff like that people really get into, and that'll help your fundraising efforts as well. But again, like I said, now, if you do plan to do a marathon, be safe about it. You know, we did have that recent news story a couple of days ago about a gamer doing a 24-hour marathon for charity who died actually during at some point during his stream. He had gotten up and walked off camera. It didn't happen on camera as far as I understand, but he did end up suffering a heart attack shortly thereafter and passing away. Now there were some extenuating circumstances that have to be taken into consideration that caused this heart attack that caused his death. It wasn't just staying up for 24 straight hours. There were some other circumstances along with that and sort of his lifestyle that sort of led to this. But nevertheless, be safe. Whatever you do for Extra Life, be safe. You know, I've done many overnight sessions in the past. Of course, this will be my fifth year of doing a 25-hour marathon. You know, suffering no ill effects other than, hey, just being sleepy the next day, which is sort of why I also do it Friday night into Saturday, because then I can sleep Saturday night and I have Sunday to just relax and actually watch some of the happenings on Extra Life as well. So, Medieval Melody, yes, indeed. I'm going to talk to my guild about that. Yes, always be safe, because you'll see, you know, so if you're watching my past marathons as well, you know, without even me thinking about it, I'll be moving around. You always want to make sure you're up, moving. You don't want to be sitting for any length of time, even like in this two-hour period. I'd want to be up and moving around, which I did with my youngest share keeping me busy. But that's the one thing, always be safe. And again, the good thing is that you don't have to do 24 straight hours. You know, be safe, think safe. Break it up. You can do 3 8-hour days, you can do 2 12-hour days, you can do 6 4-hour days, however you want to do it. But that's the important thing. Be safe, because you know we're doing this for a good cause, and we don't want to have anybody you know, make their health suffer when we're doing this to help the health of children. So whatever you do, be safe, and be sure to join us. Join us here on the Extra Life channel. Join us in our community and have fun. We have great communities here. We have a great stream team community, and lots of people with lots of ideas. So if you're ever stuck for an idea, if you're ever feeling, you know, down or think you're not doing enough, come join us here on the stream team. Come join us in our Extra Life community, and talk with people. There's a lot of great ideas out there, a lot of great gamers who will help everybody and anybody make their extra life efforts and extra life stories the best possible ones that we can do. But in the meantime, that's enough talk. We got about 40 minutes left before my good friend Aerodash comes on, and I think he mentioned he might be popping back into Knights of the Old Republic again, which is cool. But in the meantime, let's see if I can get past some of these stories let me highlight my window here again. My retrials. Oh, and I forgot to start my recording again. That's all right. I'll have to do this the hard way again. All right. Aerodash. There's Aerodash. Aerodash will be up in about 35 to 40 minutes or so. But in the meantime, let's try to get past this story again. The Apprentice. So let me get my recording going here. excuse me. Oh. All right, let's see how far I can get with this one. Yeah, so I can't advance anywhere. All right, the Apprentice. Normal, yeah, we're not going to do... Should I start new? All right, let's try continuing, then maybe we'll start new again. All right. Maybe I can get lucky here. Nope. Yeah, already. Already, here we go. Oh. Yep. Of course. Of course. I can't even get these power ups. Hey, how's the game? Frustrating. I stink at games like this, but this is even. Oh my god. No, I didn't want to retry. No. Alright, let's start the story from the beginning here. Let's go back to the easy ones. Let's start new, thanks though. Like I said earlier, this is Wand Wars here. This is a game that we actually, as part of the stream team, got a code for, and I'm beginning to regret actually trying this. Oh yes, okay, chicken, yes, okay. All right, here we go, round one, here we go, fight. Oops. Did I get it? Oh, he got it back. Oh, wow. That was pure luck there. I like the music. Music's cool. Oh, I got lucky with that. I did not think I was going to catch that. Oh, all right, got him. You're using keyboard or keyboard and mouse, which is part of the problem. After about 2 minutes of playing this game, I realized the controller would be much easier. Gotcha. I was just waiting for him to get run right into it. Now that was a lot better than my first time against this guy. Okay. Whew. All right. Jabunkin patch. Meow meow meow. Meow. Meow meow meow. Meow. Oh. Uh-oh, power up. Mm-hmm. I have no idea what this does, but let's, well, that didn't work out too well now, did it? I couldn't even see what the power-up did because I died right away. Here we go. Here's another one. All right. Oh, there we go. Oh, shoots fireballs. All right. Ah. Get it. There we go. Down, get the gem. Okay. I think I better catch this ball. Oh, ooh. Get. There we go. Ooh, gotcha. All right, there we go. Woo. Holy mackerel. Get. There we go. Well, that didn't work out so well. That's not how I planned it. There we go. I think I'm gonna miss him. Yep. Ooh, he got that power up. Oh, wow. That was sheer luck I got that rebound like that. The tiebreaker. Ooh, gotcha. All right, there we go. Okay. All right, here we go again. Yeah. Round one, fight! Ah! Of course. See, I can't get powers like that. Unbelievable! This level is so unfair. So unfair. Oh my god, really? That was pure dumb luck there. Oh, that was an interesting power there. Oh, come on. Keep distance, huh? Yeah. Yeah. Oh my god, that was lucky. That's what I gotta do. I gotta keep holding on to this thing until I can charge it up. Enough to where she can't possibly catch it. Wow, really? Wow. Yeah, chicken thing sort of makes you harmless, I guess it called it in the tutorial. Oh my god, I can't believe I didn't get hit by that thing. Shield! Oh, killing me. Oh yeah, I know, I'm a little upset too. I know, it's upsetting. This level's very upsetting. Wanna get down? Okay, give me a minute here. I gotta die another four times. And there's one. Catch it! Ooh, get out of the way. Nope. We're almost done here. Oh. Ready to get down? Okay. Come here. You want to sit with Daddy for a bit?
No.
No. Oh, already then. You just want to get down?
Yeah.
Want to sit? Yeah. What do you want to do? Okay. Say hi to everybody.
No.
No?
No.
No? Got quite the attitude. All right. One more time here. Maybe you'll bring me some luck here. See, she just... I can't get anything! I can't catch the ball, I can't get the power-ups! I can't avoid the power-ups! Oh my god. Guitar Freak, hey, what's going on? Welcome to the stream. And then I get hits like that. It just boggles the mind. It boggles the mind. Go ahead, sit. There you go. Is that better?
No.
No. No. I can't get. Wow, I got it. She can still catch it? Well, that. I got it. Oh my god! Well, it is spells. That's why it's the power-ups. It's like when she does that stuff, that's what they call the power-ups that comes up in the center of the screen. I just can't get them before she gets them. Oh my god. It's just like ridiculous. Alright, let's go back here and try the trials again. I mean, I can turn them into chickens too, but at this point, that's like too complicated for me to try. I can barely get rid of the ball, catch the ball. Wow, I don't know how I did that. There we go. Get my card. Shield bubble. Summon the shield bubble. Okay. Alright, good. Get. There we go. Into the portal we go. Get a shield on every yeah, we definitely want that one. Similar game called Lethal League, which looks kind of similar. Aha! Uh-huh. Yeah, this is the one that we got, I was telling, Medieval Melody that, this is one of the ones that we got, as a stream team reward through the email. Oh, they chickened me. Come on, there we go. I gotta get this ball back. Oh my god. Oh! There we go. Ooh-wee. The other one, I forgot what the other one was, but we got a key for the closed beta in it. I think I'm gonna need respawn gems. I was gonna try that one, but it doesn't work anymore because now the game is actually released, so I couldn't showcase that one, which we might have been better off doing. But hey, we got Wand Wars here. Wow, I don't know how I caught that. Now, this is the one that's even more unfair because I can't get powers here. I gotta catch this ball. No. Oh my god, I don't know how I escaped that. Oh my god, how did he catch that? I can't catch it! You bum! And he catches it, of course. Oh, I caught it, but he blows me up. Got him. All right. Of course, I only have one respawn left, so that does me no good. Push everything away, destroy nearby spells. That might actually come in handy. Oh, let's get my respawns. Arcane Missile and Hex Cast, huh? Okay. Alright, here we go. Dude. Heading off, alright, thanks Guitar Freak, thanks for dropping by. Summoned a friend to battle last two trials. That might actually come in handy, let's see how that one works. That was interesting, okay. That was my push everything away, I think, spell. Oh, I'm a chicken. Oh, I'm a chicken. Oh wow, I won. I don't know how I did it, but I won. Oh, hex volleys might come in handy. Alright, here we go. Oh no, he's off work just asking. Oh, okay. Oh yeah, I did hex. I should have read a little bit further up here. I'm so encapsulated trying to stay alive. Ooh. Keep spell gems in cross trials. Do spell gems. Not that I'm any good at it, but still. Sup, bud? Hey, how's it going? What I can do here is wait for these guys, and we'll go. There we go. Lather up someone in a shield bubble. Oh, okay, yeah. Definitely take that. Nothing there? Okay, I thought there was something there. Okay. Alright. Reduce spell cooldown. X arrow. Oh, let's get some health, shall we? I was 8 years old when I entered the trials. I guess that means you're older now. Oh! Yeah! Oh! Ah! Oh! No! There's no getting out of that. You have me cornered. Ah, get down! Oh, I can't move. Yeah, that was... Oh my god. Get it! Gotta get this ball. And he gets me instead. Wow, at least I got through trial 6 for crying out loud. Whew. Starts us back at trial 1. Ugh, here we go again. Time for coffee, alrighty. Yeah, I had my tea earlier just so I could try to break up some of this chest congestion I got. Ooh, okay, yeah, I'm not doing so well now, am I? Alright, we'll just let this one end, thank you. We'll let this misery end. Alright, here we go, let's try this again. Can I fire V? Oh, there we go. I chickened somebody. And I got killed anyway. So, yeah, that didn't help. Trying to do all this fancy stuff and I just shouldn't be doing that. Oh, wait. My card. Although I don't know if being faster is going to help me any here. I might end up running into this ball. Gotcha. All right, there we go. Oh yeah, definitely shield. Still sleepy, aren't you? Have you told your friends about the Wand Wars? Oh yes, they're watching me play poorly now, as my fearless judgment gaming team leader would say. Battery H. Good games played poorly, and we are certainly showcasing that today. Oh my god, 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 oh sure, chicken me, why not? That's okay. I gotta catch this ball. There we go. Catch the ball. Don't get hit by these things. Catch the ball. Catch the ball. Find an opening. Catch the ball. Oh, there goes my shield. Ah. I don't know how he did that. Oh my god, I don't know how I caught that. Oh, that was close. Yeah. Oh my god, really? Seriously? That's ridiculous. Psh, oh no, 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 no. Wow. Should I go back and try story one more time? Alright, let's go try the story one more time. Maybe I should try legendary. Yeah, I don't know. Here we go. Alright. Wow. 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 That even makes it more frustrating when I get a hit like that. Oh, got her! Wow, I actually got a power up and it worked! Oh my god, one catch the ball, catch the ball. Oh my god, I got her. One, come on, just one, just one more hit, come on, come on, come on. Oh, get out of the way, get out of the way, get out of the way! Killing me. Absolutely frustrating. Absolutely. home. That was the closest I've been so far. How does she know which way I'm going? I just don't understand. I just don't understand. Gotcha there. Yeah. Come on! Oh, I ran right into that and I saw it coming. Gotcha. Oh my god. Alright. Good enough. That's close enough to our time here, so we'll say our goodbyes. And we'll turn it over to Aerodash there. Oh my god. Well, it is definitely an interesting game, I'll say that. I guess it was fun. Yeah, it was definitely one of those games that just drives me nuts because I know I would have to beat it, and yeah, I just can't. I'll have to hook up my see if I can hook up my Xbox controller to that and see how that turns out. But yes, indeed. Oh, so that was enjoyable. Thank you for joining me today, Ray. Bun and Gunley. Oh, that was such a good round. Yeah, I know. I was so close. And that's what even makes it more frustrating, because I was so close. But we will end it here. Maybe I'll do a video of this again for a future Indie Spotlight episode on my channel. So be sure to check me out. Catch me on my channel here. Oh my god, if I can do this the correct way. Keep thinking I'm on my other own channel. There we go. But yes, be sure to I can't spell well my broken screen here. There we go. Oh, thank you Guitar Freak. It's taking me probably another 5 minutes to actually get that what I got right. Well, thank you for joining me, everyone. Thank you. It's great fun today. I'm enjoying these Mondays, even despite the early on baby disasters here, right? Yes. Oh yes, a little child. But yeah, be sure to check us out at Extra Life, www.extra-life.org. Like I said, like I've been saying through the whole broadcast, you know, everybody can do this. It's really quick, it's really easy, it's a lot of fun for a great cause. You can play all sorts of different types of games, whatever floats your boat, whatever suits your fancy. You can play Wand Wars for 24 hours if you want to. You can break up your marathons, but always be safe when you're doing your marathons. But be sure to join us, because the more people we have, the more potential money we can raise. And always donate to yourself. That's one of the first things you should always do, is throw a couple of bucks towards your own donation. That way, you know, when people see your donation page, say, hey, look, this guy believes in his own cause. You can even do it anonymously, so, you know, it looks like nobody knows where the donation came from, if that's what you want to do. But you should always show a donation from yourself. Donate to your own cause, because that gets people saying, hey, this guy believes in what he's doing. He's putting his own money into this cause as well. So $9.1 million raised, over $9.1 million raised, actually. in 2016. So this is our ninth year of Extra Life. You know, the first year I came through, what was it, 1,200 gamers. I don't think they have $302,000 between 2008 and 2009. So in less than a decade, we've exponentially increased that amount, over $9.1 million last year. This year, I think, you know, I think we can hit the $10 million mark. In 2015, we had $8.3 million. So I think we're very, very good chance of hitting the $10 million mark this time around. So enough talking from me. I'm taking into Aerodash's time. So let me get Aerodash on, because I think he's got KOTOR planned up for today. So let me get out of here. Thank you, everyone. It's BJ Wallace saying, until next time, I will see you in game. Sure to sign up. Check us out. Come join us. We have cookies.